Well, just Frank, you know, going in, you've had several phases of your career around the CFL. How's it feel going in these circumstances here?
Well, it's terrific. I think builder was probably the correct category for me. I'm very happy with that and happy to be with the other five players who are being inducted.
Great passion for the CFL. You've written books on it and everything. Where did all that passion come from?
Well, I went to the University of Alberta in 1967, and I knew they had a master's program in sport history in physical education. And, you know, the old cliche is write about something you know. So I had 7 years of football under my belt. Nobody had done a history of football in Canada from the Grey Cup on. And so I decided to do it. And came out in I completed it in 1968 and graduated, was accepted for my PhD, and the thesis was turned into a book called Canadian Football, the Great Cup Years, and then it just steamrolled from there. It just everything that I kind of prepared myself for through football was opening doors, and it was great. I still marvel at the way it turned out.
You've been enshrined in a number of Hall of Fames over your career. How does this one? Where does this one sit in sort of your sort of list of honors?
Well, put it that way. Yeah, it's always nice to be recognized, of course, and the CFL. I know that the it's a builders in the Canadian Football Hall of Fame rather than the Canadian Football League Hall of Fame. So I'm pleased that I'm being recognized as having contributed to the growth of football, totally, professional and amateur, in Canada, and it ranks right up there with, second to my wife and children.
It's probably safe to say that, right? You got to make sure you get that in there.
Where's the league now?
I think the league has really turned around. I think when the CFL came back from the States, and Baltimore moved to Montreal, and Montreal moved from the Big O to McGill Stadium. You got all these crowds now finding that the CFL was an interesting game. They were glad to have it back. And I think with the contracts that they've been able to sign with the TSN, it just has meant there's been a little bit more money to spend. Our rosters have increased. The rosters have increased really up to 46. When I played, the rosters were 32. So that extra 14 people means that you can better special teams, better one-way contracts as far as positions and things like that. I think it's come a long way, and it's really on a steep incline.
What kind of a player were you?
Well, I played quarterback. I probably wouldn't have played any other position, although I did go out as a receiver a couple of times. But what kind of a player was I? When I first started, I went out for my first football team when I was 12 years old. I came from an immigrant family, so I played sports where all you needed was a pair of sneakers and the equipment was provided. So I played in an old boys association in Hamilton as an end. Then I went to high school and I tried out with the junior football team at my high school three times, and three times in a row I was cut. So then my father happened to die when I was 16, and I was still in high school, and I was playing baseball all this time, and I was a pretty good baseball pitcher. The football coach came up to me and said, "We're losing our quarterback next week. They tell me you've got a strong arm. I'd like you to go down to the gymnasium, actually to the cafeteria with our center, and work on snaps and handoffs and things like that, to see if you can prepare yourself for next season." So I did, and I was looking forward to the next season. And in the meantime, he took a job in Boston. So a new coach was coming in from Notre Dame. The bishop in Hamilton was a staunch Notre Dame supporter. And so the new coach came in. I went out as a football team and as a quarterback with the football team. And he initiated the split T offense. So we went on a three-day retreat to a Catholic Loyola college and had a retreat, but also practiced football. And every play that I ran, my best friend was playing defense, and he was knocking me flat on my back. So I finally, I says, what's going on? Why are you hitting me? And he says, coach told me. He says, split two, you're going to get hit in every play. So I've got to hit you every play. So now that I knew the rules of the game, then I started anticipating the hit and going back and saw it. But to make a long story short, so I played as a quarterback that year and the following year in high school. We won our championship in the first year I played. Second year we won the league title, but we got beaten in the championship game.
Yeah.
By that time, I wasn't a good student at the time. But if I passed, I knew I could one more year of high school football. And when I passed in grade 13 at that time, I had interest from a number of schools, including some in the States. And it was another excuse to go and play football. At that time, I had moved away from baseball and into football. Went to Western University and played football there for 4 years. Drafted by Hamilton, played seven at Hamilton, two with Edmonton, and one with Toronto. And all those years as a quarterback. That's kind of long-winded, I know.
Not many Canadian quarterbacks left, though, right? I mean, it's you're one of the last Canadian quarterbacks to play an extended period of time, right?
Yeah, and it's kind of interesting, too, because Russ Jackson, of course, was.
Yeah.
Russ and I played baseball until I was 12. He's 1 year older than I. So we played baseball together on the same team in Hamilton. But he went to Westdale School and I went to Cathedral School. And because he was 1 year ahead of me, we never really either played against each other until he was in Ottawa and then I went to Hamilton, because McMaster wasn't in the same conference as Western at that time. I sure wish there were more Canadian quarterbacks. I'm glad to see someone like Brandon Bridge rising to the occasion. And hopefully he'll be identified as a quarterback, not just a Canadian quarterback.
Yeah.
Although, I know he's trying to perhaps not be identified. He'd like to be identified, I should say, as a Canadian quarterback, so that people have the opportunity to know that a Canadian can play quarterback. When I was at York University, I tried to recruit a really good Canadian quarterback in high school from Northern Collegiate. I had played football at Western with the coach, Clark Pulford. And so I went down to see this young fellow, and he said, I was trying to convince him he could come and play quarterback with York. He says, I don't want to play quarterback. The guy was 6'4". Weighed about 200 pounds, could throw the ball really well. And I said, well, why not? He says, because I want to play in the CFL, and I won't be able to play in the CFL as a quarterback, but I can go to Simon Fraser, and they'll take me as an offensive end, and I'll play in the CFL. And he did, and he played 1 year, but he met his goal anyway.
Is this, do you have another book in you about the CFL, or is this the last chapter?
Well, no, Dave, let me see. I wrote three books on the CFL.
Yeah.
The first one was Canadian Football and Great Cup Years. The second one was A Passing Game. That was 300 and some odd pages, and the publisher went bankrupt a couple of years ago. So I had the rights, and I split it up into two books. And the first book is called Closed Doors and Alberta Crew. And the second book is Gone South. So it deals with all the same stuff that was in A Passing Game. And then the fourth book is called Home Again. And it only goes up to 2015. But I've been carrying on and catching up with everything. And when it's time for a renewal, maybe in a couple of years, I'll maybe change the title a little bit or change the years, because I enjoy doing it.
And now you can add yourself as a Hall of Famer.
Well, hey, make an entry, that's right. Yeah, sure. Well, that's great, yeah.